growing up Tongan and woman. The weight of whatongia and whakapa'apa were sculpted into my vocabulary before I knew the sound of my own name. Whatongia, meaning responsibility, whakapa'apa, meaning respect, these were the first principles carved into my young mind, the first of many expectations I would be forced to memorize ma'uloto until it becomes a chant representing the only priorities I am allowed to have for centuries. Our women have been engraving these rules into the wrists of their daughters, never noticing how closely they resemble to handcuffs, sentencing the next generation of the ahine to a life of being placed on the front line but never given an opportunity to speak. Instead, I have been taught how to puno and to low past ulumo to us, how to tau lalo and fola haka when asked to tau olunga, how to accommodate and serve until I cannot help but question the point in having a voice at all. And Tonga, your dad's elder sister sits at the top of the family hierarchy. My people pride ourselves in sustaining a culture that is built upon the foundations of a matriarchy, preaching the gospel in one hand as if we are not suffocating our women with the other until all they can say is tulo, whakamole mole tulo, and everything else is a muffled silence. So let me speak and I will yell and shout and scream until my chest tightens, the walls of my throat bleed red, coughing up blood in between cries like the women whose bodies you have too often mistaken for ngatus on the living room floor. I will speak even when you tighten the kahoa he lala around my neck, use the gifts of my motherland against her and offspring, pray for the day my words stay suppressed inside my throat. I will show you what a reckoning looks like, the rage of a pent-up cyclone. Burn your high horse down with my bare hands. I'll be goddamned if you ever forget my name. I will speak, carve my words into weaponry, making spears from the sentences accumulating on the tip of my tongue. The next person who tries to speak over my voice will be left covered in cuts and bruises. One scar for every tulo I was forced to feed to undeserving mouths. I will speak, harness the story of every matriarch forced into submission, carry it with all the remaining strength my arms have left. You will feel their pain and the trembling of my breath. You will feel the venom of their legacy piercing through your skin. You will see their faces, their flesh, their blood. Our kuifefines did not lead villages to prosperity for their granddaughters to grow up silent. So I will speak, I will speak, I will speak, and you will fucking listen.